Welcome, I'm Jessica Hess, Program Coordinator of Surveying Technology, and in this video, we'll learn that in surveying, angles are most commonly measured with total stations or robotic total stations. These instruments are also capable of measuring distances. Equipment needed to measure angles and distances is a total station, a tripod, prism poles with prism targets and bipods, three marked points on the ground, and a field book. Begin by unlocking the tripod legs and dropping them until the head is chest height. Then expand them to make a wide base. Position them over the top of a point and attach the total station snugly but not overly tight. Place a toe next to the point, sight through the optical plummet, and maneuver two of the tripod legs until you see the point through the plummet. Set the tripod legs down and step them into the ground. Sight through the optical plummet again and adjust the foot screws until the crosshairs are centered over the point. Unlock and slide the legs to rough level the round plate bubble, getting it at least partially inside the ring. Then fine level the instrument using the foot screws in the tube or digital bubble. Check to make sure the instrument is still centered over the point. If it is not, loosen it just enough to slide it into position. Then check the fine level again and make adjustments if necessary. Repeat this process until the instrument is fine leveled and centered over the point. Set temperature, pressure, and prism settings in the instrument for accurate measurements and adjust the telescope for parallax. The prism poles are positioned and leveled on the remaining two points and aimed toward the total station. Five pieces of data are utilized in total station measurement for control. They are organized in your field book as shown. An occupy point, noting where the instrument is located. A backsight point, noting the back direction with a distance. A foresight point, noting the forward direction with a description of the point. And then horizontal angles and distances. Angles can be measured in direct mode and reverse mode. The modes are switched by flipping the telescope over. Always start in direct mode. We are now ready to measure. Begin by pointing the total station in direct mode at the center of the lowest part of the backsight pole and locking its horizontal motion. Then pan it up to the prism and lock the vertical motion. Set 0 degrees, 0 minutes, and 0 seconds in the instrument and measure a distance. Then record these items in the field notes. This will be the only time we take a distance measurement on the backsight. We will only take distance measurements on the foresight from here on out. Unlock the instrument and turn it toward the foresight, sighting this pole in the same way. Lock down the instrument, measure a distance, and record the horizontal angle and distance in the field book. Notice these entries denote the measurements are in direct mode with the D designation. Unlock the instrument and flip the telescope into reverse mode. Point it back to the backsight, lock down the motion, and record only the horizontal angle. Notice these entries denote the measurements are in reverse mode with the R designation. Once recorded, unlock the instrument and point it toward the foresight. Lock it down, but this time take a horizontal distance measurement and record both it and the horizontal angle. We have now finished one set of angles. We want to repeat the process one more time, as it takes two sets of angles to produce the accuracy ability of the instrument. Once all measurements are completed, average the angles and distances to obtain final values. Here are some things to remember. Make sure the instrument is leveled and centered over the point before beginning measuring. Set temperature, pressure, and prism settings. Start the measurements in direct mode. Thank you for joining me for total station measurement for survey control. Look for our other educational videos to learn more about surveying.